Hey everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to get your Leap Motion Controller set up in Cartoon Animator 4. The Leap Motion Controller is a quick and inexpensive way to capture dynamic hand motion for your characters in no time at all. The first thing you'll want to do is go to the Leap Motion website in order to download and install the standalone application. Choose the desktop version and the V4 SDK in order to download and install the standard version. Keep in mind that version 3.2 SDK is also available, and you'll also need to register for a Leap Motion account before downloading. After you've completed installation, go ahead and open up the Leap Motion control panel. In the General tab, make sure that the Allow Web Apps checkbox is active. In the Troubleshooting tab, run through the checklist and ensure that the surface of your Leap Motion device is clean in order to set each status to green in the device status group. Next, it's important to activate low resource mode, which will enhance your performance when capturing your motion with Motion Live 2D. After you've finalized your settings, simply select Apply. Next, you'll want to go into the Diagnostic Visualizer in order to determine the best detection range for your hands. There is a prompt telling you to press H for help, which will bring up a list of hotkeys once pressed. To see the range guidelines, use the L hotkey. We'll zoom out a bit to get a better view, and you'll notice that when your hands leave the capture range, the palms will flip over, indicating that the range has been exceeded. Also, be aware that when you're close to the edge of the capture range, you may experience excessive jittering, as certain parts of the hands may be outside the range of the device. In addition to the limit range, there are also dead zones for capture according to the position of your hands. You'll notice that the device is on the table here, and when we move the fingers directly over the wrists, it can't determine exactly where they are due to occlusion caused by the palm and the wrist. This will result in incorrect display of the fingers. The same thing will happen if you turn your palm facing upwards and curl your fingers inwards, as they'll be blocked from the sensor by your palm. To connect the Motion Live 2D plugin, go up to the plugin menu and select it. The character you have selected will show up on the character list. Click the hollow circle beside the Leap Motion controller in order to connect your gear to the plugin, and then activate the correct gear profile under the hand column. Once your character's name and data source appear on the right side, you can click the preview button and hit the space bar to preview the initial hand tracking result. In order to get the most accurate result, you need to set a zero pose to calibrate the device before you use it. If we try to capture before setting the zero pose, you'll see that the fingers are still a little bit crooked. To calibrate, first select Set Zero Pose. You can set the timer here, and when you're ready, just press Start to get your hands in position. For the first pose, you'll want to make sure that your hands are all stretched out and your fingers are completely straight. Once the first pose is done, you'll need to switch to the second. For the second pose, simply bunch your hands up into a fist. Once you record now, you'll see that the hand results are a lot more accurate, as the fingers are now straight in Cartoon Animator after setting the zero pose. Also note that the raw data is rotated slightly in the diagnostic visualizer here. Let's take a look at the four different control modes now. We'll look at hand control first. If we preview, you can see that regardless of how the forearms move, only the hands are moving on the character model. The hands will also automatically flip in response to user control. If we deselect auto hand flip, then the model's hands won't flip regardless of actions by the user. We'll keep that on and take a look at finger control next. As you can probably guess, this mode will only drive the finger animation despite movement of both the hands and forearms. Pretty straightforward. In forearm IK mode, motions from the elbows to the fingers will all be captured. If you want, you can show or hide the hand effectors, which are the little gizmos placed right near the wrists of your character. If we preview, you can see that they will follow along with the wrists of the character, and the upper arms of the character will remain stationary. The forearm perspective option will scale down the forearm bones in order to generate an illusion of perspective on the forearms. Because we have it selected, when you bring your arms down, your character will appear to do the same via automatic scaling of your model's forearms. If we disable this, you'll notice that regardless of the movement by the actor, the model's arms will not create this illusion of moving towards the viewer. Finally, let's take a look at upper arm IK. Here you can see what you'd probably expect, full arm movement all the way from the shoulders to the fingers. An option to be aware of in this control mode is auto elbow and wrist flip. With this enabled, your character model will react a bit more naturally when you're moving your arm around. Upper arm IK will automatically flip your character's elbow direction when your hands are in different quadrants, so be aware of this. If this is disabled, you may see some awkward looking motions depending on your movement. This also applies in side profile view as well. If we don't have elbow flip enabled, we'll get the weird, awkward result like you see here. One way to resolve this is to use the elbow flip option on our character's left arm. Once we do that, you'll see that the elbow flip issue is resolved when we use the hand to drive the motion of the character's arm. Next, we'll look at profile and motion presets. You can see that we have three different profiles for hand and arm capture: front-facing, left-facing, and right-facing. There are also a number of motion presets which we'll go through now. Let's start with the standard front-facing male stand-up. When we preview, you can see that he will go into the default pose, and since we have upper arm IK enabled, the whole arms will move. Next, let's try another pose where the arms are crossed but the character is still standing. This time around, we'll restrict our character's arm movement to lower arms by selecting forearm IK, in order to keep the upper arms crossed. It's recommended to use the forearm IK mode when using the cross preset, simply to ensure that the arms use that initial crossed arm pose as a reference. As with the standing poses, there are also a number of seated poses. This is just the basic seated pose, and can be used for certain scenarios, maybe like a seated person telling a story. There's also a seated pose preset with crossed arms, which could possibly be used by someone stroking their chin while listening to a story. In this next example, our model is facing to the left, so let's use the same profile with upper arm IK enabled. This will allow us to move the entire arm on both sides. This could be a useful pose for boxing or another motion that requires full arm movement. In this next example, we'll use the same side profile, but this time only with forearm IK, which will lock the movement of the upper arm. This is an excellent profile to quickly capture perhaps a professor in a lecture, or someone teaching a classroom or having a conversation from a side perspective. The seated pose is great for something like typing on a computer from a side perspective, and we can use the alternate pose for something like the aforementioned storytelling while seated, only this time from a side perspective. So that's about all there is to it. Using the Leap Motion controller for hand and upper arm capture in Cartoon Animator is a quick and efficient tool that can provide you with natural, smooth, and dynamic animation for things like gestures and expressions in no time to speed up your production workflow. The scene you see here can be completed within a couple of minutes thanks to these amazing tools. Thanks so much for watching, everyone, and make sure you check out our forums at forum.reallusion.com to learn and discuss more about Cartoon Animator 4 with our community, and I hope to see you in the next video.